most hardcore Lions fan.
There could be a revolt. There would be a revolt.
This is one I don't even care who the quarterback is. You can't do this. This ranks right up there. Michigan getting blasted by Ohio State, and we're giving him an extension. There's certain things you just can't do with sports. This is one. You can't do it to your fan base. Every now and then, you just got to look at the people who support you and say, nah, we got to do better by them. And this is one, you got to do better. I hope it's a Zoom. I hope he's not flying in. This isn't even worth it. Because here's the problem that I have is you don't interview people who I guess you don't think could possibly have the job. And he shouldn't even be an option. Let's hope this smart people come together and make sure that this doesn't happen because, there's nothing like this.
List. How does he make the list, Rico?
You planned on Kenny Pott before Scott Paola. Because she said she wanted before Scott Paola. She wanted somebody with experience, and he was once the hot name, like 10, 12 years ago. He was that guy.
I think it was the off season of 08 when he was at his peak entry that he was a hot name. People wanted him. And look, nobody ripped the Chiefs. I bet you if I went back to 08, 09, I didn't rip the Chiefs. Everybody wanted to give him a shot. He bombed. That's it. You don't get a second chance in this league. You know what he is? He was about as hot as Eric Bieniemy is right now as a coach. 10 years from now, we're going to be like, I can't believe that team actually took Eric Bieniemy. But at the time, he was that name. That was 12 years ago. And your resume since is, you helped build a Falcon team that lost in the Super Bowl. There's Duke. Well, and again, you're the assistant GM.
I said help.
Get the shine for you.
Right. I said help.
Yeah.
But, this is out.
Okay. So, again, due diligence is one thing. This is outer space, so keep your eye on it. I don't know when Pioli's going to interview, but they're interviewing Lewis Riddick tomorrow. I assume they will interview Rick Smith if they haven't already. And the names will continue to come out. I'm glad I haven't heard any more buzz about Jerry Reese. Hopefully we put that one to bed. But the interest of this is going to be when or if they begin people from the organizations, right? Show me somebody with the Ravens or the Colts.
Before we go to the break, is there a name? Is there somebody that, or a couple names that you really hope to see?
Okay.
This is, I like this guy. Keep an eye on this guy.
I think I can give you a profile of what I would find to be good, but I can't give you a name because I think it's dishonest. Like, I hate when guys in our business go out and they're like, you got to go hire Bob O'Reilly. We have no idea. We don't get to know these people. We don't know. it's unrealistic to say. Now open at the award-winning BetRivers.com.
season, you're in sales event at Sarah Kia. Save on our new line of winter-ready vehicles today. Check out the beautiful 2021 Kia Sportage available right now with $1,000 holiday bonus cash and 0% financing for up to 66 months with approved Kia Motor financing. With our network of over 20 different lenders, Sarah Kia can get you the credit that other dealers can't. Whether you're looking for a vehicle for yourself or your children, shop Sarah Kia for your best deal. If you have limited time, shop and buy online at drivesarahkia.com. 0% offer available to residents of Michigan for Kia Motor finance with 15% to 1,000 finance. Not all buyers will qualify, subject to KMF approval.
What's in store this holiday at Staples?
Gifts and packages shipped with care.
So you can relax knowing they'll soon be there.
Now at Staples, save 25% on UPS expedited shipping services.
Plus, take up to 30% off select shipping supplies, like boxes, tape, and padded mailers.
Shop in store or get it same day with Instacart.
And save on holiday shipping at Staples.
In store only. Offers end 1/2/21. See store for details. Instacart not available on shipping services. Fees, taxes, additional terms, and or tips may apply. Delivery subject to availability.
Some peace and quiet? What questions find you? Merrill Lynch Self-Directed Investing can help you find answers with personalized planning tools and insights to help you get where you want to go, even if it's just downstairs. Merrill, a Bank of America company. Visit MerrillLynch.com/withinreach to get started today.
Investing involves risk. Merrill Lynch Pierce Fetter and Smith Incorporated, registered broker-dealer member SIPC. Investment products are not FDIC insured or not bank guaranteed and may lose value.
Whatever you send through the U.S. Postal Service this season is so much more than mail.
Still gonna go, but I think it's gonna make Michigan's job harder. I think
question. Do you feel like there was an overreaction or this overwillingness to pile on PJ Fleck because he's so annoying? Like,
yes.
He started the year with a bunch of COVID. He had his players opt out, then opt back in. But they were never going to go and win 10, 11 games again this year. But people seemingly all of a sudden, because of the row the boat from, do you feel like that was an overreaction by his critics?
It is, because he's different. Like, he's not your normal coach. He says things, he runs with his players, and at the end of the fourth quarter, he takes off and sprints to the end of the field. As you say, he dresses like a barber, does different things. And a lot of coaches see that and like, ah, it's a gimmick. And that's what that guy gets for trying to run that gimmick. I do think it was piling on. I do think it was unfair. I like PJ Fleck is building at Minnesota. I thought it would be better this year, but it wasn't. But I do agree. I do think it was a piling on because of who it was. At number five. Well, here's a team that probably couldn't have started any worse than they did at 0-5, but my goodness, their last three wins, very impressive, including a second half where they corrected the problems. And my goodness, it pains me to say James Franklin made smart moves in the second half because I just don't think that he is a really good coach.
No.
But Penn State at number five. They started off this year 0-5, and we all saw that controversial play at the end of the Indiana game that kind of took the two teams in different directions. Penn State never recovered, and Indiana just kept skyrocketing.
Conference call too.
But Penn State at five, they won their last three.
Do you think any coach was hurt more in the Big Ten by playing this year than James Franklin?
They didn't do it last week.
I do. Because at least
canceled him. They used to do him every day.
I don't think he's like the opposite of PJ Fleck. I don't think he got as much flack because people saw how many people had opted out. He was down to his fifth string running back. It was just so many problems that they just said, "Yeah, we understand." Where Fleck, they, "Nah, you're a funny looking guy and you say funny things like row the boat." There were other coaches that got hit worse. But, I mean, we talked about him in the other segment. I think that basically Scott Frost and Jim Harbaugh, it hurt them playing this season.
No, that's fair. Franklin is in this weird space of guy who's won some things, but you feel like the fan base is turning on him because everyone's figuring out he's a snake oil salesman and not a game manager.
You know who he is? He is the Big Ten version of Ed Orgeron.
Where's my bell? Spot on. Except he doesn't sound nearly as cool.
Right, but I think no one at LSU was sitting there going to ask for Easy Ed's head. You know what? This year didn't count. Whatever.
You know what? Do you think Easy, and I know we're getting away from where we need to go with the rankings.
Let's talk about any conference other than Big Ten. I'm fine with that.
Could Orgeron end up going the way of Gene Chizik?
Meaning?
From like a championship to fired 2 years later.
Yes.
Yes, he's got the scandal. His season was a disaster. If they don't perform next year, wouldn't he be on the hot seat the year after?
Yes.
You mean a homer?
Tell him about it, JoJo.
Here's the thing. Here's why you are correct, Mike. He was about to be fired last year. They didn't want him.
Welcome to Death Valley.
He just went out there and won the national title, and folks were like, oh, okay. But every year, they tried to find anybody else but Orgeron to be the coach.
Bottom line is this. Nobody does it better. Hummer Automotive commercial. That 2005 Ole Miss ad is the stuff of
legend.
I'm quite sure JoJo hates you.
We actually called that dealership, our listeners called, asking for JoJo. JoJo's been gone for about 6 or 7 years, and we don't have proof of life.
I was about to say, hopefully JoJo's not dead. That would be an awkward call.
that team together. Iowa, I thought it was going to be utter disaster with all the racial overtones and undertones going in the program. They're the hottest team. They lost two games, and other than that, they just been killing everybody. And, of course, at one.
No, I have a question on Iowa. Okay. Don't steamroll this. I'm participating. Standard question here. Is Kirk Ferentz a witch or a vampire?
I'm thinking he's a vampire because Iowa is a lot harder to play at night.
Dude, all the things you mentioned don't matter. This dude is like the undead. You can't kill Kirk Ferentz.
No.
You can't kill that program.
No. Been there 20 years. You're like, wow, he doesn't look a day over 40. Like, how old is he?
I mean, what is this, a skin cream ad? All right, who's number one?
And number one? Come on, man. Ohio State.
There you go. I don't have any questions. I don't care.
Hey, Mike.
For Ohio State.
Here's a question for you. Should Ohio State be considered for the playoffs, even though they've only played seven games?
100%. 100%. I'm not putting in Florida over there. I'm not putting in Texas A&M. I'm not putting in a two-loss Iowa State. Yes, they're one of the four best teams in America.
Yes.
In
97-1.
Well, the holidays are happier gifts from Paulson. Save on those great gifts and home upgrades in audio, video, home theater, and smart home, and a whole lot more. You do it with Paulson's audio video. They got the most convenient ways to shop this year. They make it so easy to get what you need. You can call in your order ahead of time, pick up the exact products. Contactless curbside service. For the person who's got everything, they're offering gift certificates. Maybe the best gift of all, they got 12 months financing. So shop now, pay later, and get whatever kick-ass home audio and video you need for your house. Here's the deal. You don't remember anything, just remember, the prices are always lower than Amazon Prime or Best Buy, and they put it in writing. It's Paulson's Audio Video, paulsonsav.com, Paulson's Audio Video, the toy store for grown-ups.
This Radio.com Sports Minute is brought to you by North Bloomfield Properties.
I'm Jim Rome with a Radio.com Sports Minute sponsored by Geico. 15 minutes can save you 15% or more on car insurance. Ever since James Harden showed up on Tuesday night for the Rockets, he has been taking lots of heat. He nearly broke Twitter with the reactions to that one photo of him looking more like James Harden than James Harden. So he finally got in front of the media, and the media said, how did going to Atlanta and Vegas help you there when the Rockets were starting training camp in Houston? And his response was, quote, just, you know, my personal trainers. Bam. Case closed. Personally, I'm great with this explanation. And everybody who was clowning him for partying in Atlanta and Vegas and showing up out of shape probably feel pretty dumb right about now. And you should. Harden knows exactly what he's doing. Eating, drinking, and getting fat. I'm Jim Rome.
Do you rent your home?
Sure you do.
And I bet it can be hard work. You know what's easy? Bundling policies with Geico. Geico makes it easy to bundle your renter's insurance along with your auto policy. It's a good thing, too, because you already have so much to do around your home. Go to geico.com, get a quote, and see how much you could save. It's Geico easy. Visit geico.com today. That's geico.com. Again, that's geico.com.
Is the cost of finishing the basement worth manifesting peace and quiet? What questions find you? Merrill Edge Self-Directed Investing can help you find answers with personalized planning tools and insights to help you get where you want to go, even if it's just downstairs. Merrill, a Bank of America company. Visit MerrillEdge.com/withinreach to get started today.
Investing involves risk. Merrill Edge Pierce Fenner & Smith Incorporated, registered broker dealer member SIPC. Investment products are not FDIC insured or not bank guaranteed or may lose value.
Hey, Michiganders, have you been waiting for online sports betting? I'm excited to finally tell you it's almost here, and I have some good news to go along with it. If you register your account early with FanDuel Sportsbook, you'll get $100 in free bets once they go live. No deposit required. Just sign up, verify your account, and you're all set. FanDuel Sportsbook app is easy, safe, and fast. It's easy to register, make a deposit, and quick. 770-7117 for confidential help.
I am David Hall from Hall Financial. Mortgage interest rates are at historic lows, and now's the time to have Hall Financial refinance your home loan. You can shave years off your loan, cut down your payment, or consolidate your debt. Hall Financial can even close your loan in half the time of the competition, all while giving you five-star service. Don't miss out on these historically low rates. Visit DavidHallMortgage.com and start saving now.
Hall Financial, NMLS ID 1467435, Equal Housing Lender.
Failing finish 2020 is going out of Kelly and is met by Dodge Aurora to lease the Dodge Challenger Scat Pack for $339 per month at Dodge.com.
Nobody likes you because you always take it one step too far.
The Boys to Men Christmas song is not a Christmas song.
You don't like it, but it's not ridiculous. They're not a horrible group. You always take it the next step.
It's not a Christmas song.
I feel like about Elvis. I hate Elvis, and this is not a Christmas song.
Correct.
See, no snack hours, no bells, no chimes. It's just singing under a melody.
All right, guys.
Buffalo for Brian McKnight. If you could put it this way, Roberto, the next time he comes, you go to a Brian McKnight concert with your wife. Brian does all the work. All you got to do is say nothing in the car on the way home.
Hey, don't ruin it.
How would that be any? How would that be different than any other car ride he has? No. But anything you say will only screw that night up.
No, I will say, I've
guaranteed money in the bank. Say nothing.
I've used his second album many a time in the hot tub days.
It was like going to a Luther concert back in the day. With money in the bag, you just sit there. Yep. You'd be like Kenny.
One after the other.
You'd be making demands like Kenny did yesterday.
Stop here. doesn't seem realistic.
Scouting the Bronx seems actually too easy. That seems like the low-hanging fruit. But what's more awesome than getting invited to a LeBron team dinner and then saying, nah, I'm good on that pass? That's Rico Beer. That's my guess.
Right, like he went home and read Stan Lee comics. All right, I'm actually going with the classic. So, shout out Stan Lee. Oh, wait,
yes, I listened to the Temptations Christmas album.
That's right. Rico is the recruiting guy on this show, but I do think that would be too easy. Plus, it was like 20-some-odd years ago. I don't even know if Rico was like out of school, because Rico, little known fact, has a PhD. He was in school until he was like 35. The LeBron mistress thing does seem like creepy Roberto's infusion into the segment, right? I'm going to go with he got invited to an after-game dinner or party and couldn't go because he was busy having a threesome with Brian McKnight.
Well, here's the funny thing, guys. Roberto, in one of his made-up ones, actually, we can combine two games. He actually hit upon something that I'm too degrees from, because I know one of Delonte West's teachers from high school. So, yeah.
So you're telling me it's true. Delonte really did.
Well, Roberto made that fact up, and I'm sitting there thinking, Roberto, I gave you how to give this clue, and you went off script. So there were two things that were actually true, and you two losers picked the one that wasn't true.
It's LeBron and a bunch of average.
Matthew McConaughey is extremely overrated.
All right. First of all, I think number two sounds so absurd. There's no way it could be true. And if it is, I'll just leave the show today. There's no way that he sees McConaughey on a regular basis. So I'm out on that.
I mean,
and Rico, the reason we're friends is we're just complete opposites. He probably thinks McConaughey's an insufferable douche. So number three is where I'm going. I bet you he thinks McConaughey is totally overrated. I'll go number three. Kenny.
A lot of people think McConaughey's overrated, so I'm not going to go there. The same way where a lot of people like you, Mike, think that he's great. But I do see this as being another one of those random Rico acts of knowing somebody being 1 degree of separation away or 0 degrees of separation. So I'm going to go with the second one. He sees him in New Orleans.
He said that they just see each other. Yeah. They don't know. You know,
that's fine. They bump into each other. I can see that for sure.
All right. Rico.
I'll simply say this. Matthew McConaughey plays the exact same role.
Yes.
In every movie.
That's my guy. That's my special guy right there.
He can't act. He's just, I mean, it's Shaquille O'Neal, Beyonce, Matthew McConaughey.
You'd all right, so like even a movie that was recent, you didn't like McConaughey and the Gentleman, the guy Richie Fink.